Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel Python Freaks. So today's video is coming after a long gap. So sorry for keeping you wait for such a long time. So based on the recommendation from couple of people, I am making this particular video, and I think by now you might have read the title. So today's topic is roadmap for learning Selenium. So in this particular video, we are going to discuss about the complete end-to-end roadmap for learning Selenium from scratch. And it will not be only limited to learning, but our goal will be to make you ready for a job interview, followed by how actually you can work on Selenium in a real-time project. And yes, we'll request you to watch the video till the very end, as during the end, I will be showing you a real working code of Selenium so that you can understand the full picture on how Selenium actually works. So before we start with Selenium, let's first quickly discuss how Selenium was developed, or how actually the idea of Selenium came. So, Jason Huggins, he was an engineer at ThoughtWorks, and he was working at Chicago, and he was performing some manual tests. And then he found out that whatever he was doing was very repetitive and boring. So, he developed a JavaScript program to automate that particular testing of web application, which initially he called it as JavaScript Test Runner. But down the line in the future, this particular Java TestScript runner came to be updated as Selenium. So this was actually how Selenium was developed. Now, let's discuss about what actually Selenium is. So in layman terms, if I have to define Selenium, then it would be that Selenium is an open source tool that is used for automating the test carried out on web browser. Now, let's try to understand this particular definition in two parts. So the first part is test running on any browser. So since it's a web automation, so definitely it will be needing some platform or some browser on which this particular test will be done. So this platform can be any browser. It can be Mozilla, it can be Chrome, it can be Internet Explorer as well. So this was all about platform on which test will run. Now let's come to the second part, which is, what is actually this test? Okay, let's say you have logged into Facebook. Okay, you feeded your username and you feeded your password. And once the login is successful, the home page of your Facebook opens. So this is actually a very simple use case, or we can call it as a simple test of Selenium, which can run on any browser. Now, think about this in a very bigger platforms. So in internet, you do lots of browsing, logging, buying something, or even online chattings. So all these are something can be transformed into Selenium test. But for now, let's take an example of shopping. Let's say you are shopping online, and there will be multiple phases of it. Like you will first check the product. Okay, then you will verify all the different spec of it, and then you will finally buy it. But then again, even after you have decided to buy something, there will be a multiple steps or multiple phases to it. Like the account needs to be verified, the credit card and the debit card needs to be entered, then the payment needs to be completed, and once the payment has been verified, then your purchase will be successful. So this is from a simple to complex test, like all this, like payment gateway, how you will enter the like your credit card, debit card, how you will basically browse all the products. So all these are simple tests, but together, if we see, this is entirely a whole functionality which we check. So this is what Selenium does. Like all these actions, all these small actions can be verified via Selenium, and this can be done on any browser. So this is what Selenium does in a very concise way. All the functionality which you see on web, it can be on any online portal, it can be any e-commerce website, or as a matter of fact, anything which you see on web can be automated via Selenium. Now, why actually we need Selenium? So like all this functionality which is being developed, let's say the example of an e-commerce website. So before it's released to the end user, it needs to be tested, and this is taken care by Selenium in a very simple and flawless way. However, not everything can be automated, but you can consider that most of the things or actions which you do on website or which you see on website can be automated via Selenium. So this was pretty much about Selenium. Now, let's move to the next part. How can we learn Selenium? What all things we need to know to crack the interview of a Selenium? Or how can we actually start working on a Selenium? What all things which we need to prepare for? So, at the very top level, these are the four things which is required, which you can see in the screen. Now, there can be debate on adding few things or removing few things, but that's a very general or a personal opinion. But you can consider these are the four basic things you need to know to start working on Selenium. Okay, so the first one on the list is scripting language. Now, as we know, Selenium is just a tool. So to run our test, we need one scripting language, which can be Java, C# or Python. Now, if your question is which one is the best, so there will be no well-defined answer for this. You can go ahead with any language which you are comfortable with. It can be even Java or C#, whichever you are working on. But now, since I have worked on Python, so I am very comfortable with Python. So I will choose Python simply because the syntax is very simple and the code which is written is very precise and short. But like I said, if you are already working on Java or any other language, just check Selenium is supported for that particular language or not, and you are good to go. You can take that particular language and work with Selenium and automate whatever use case you want to automate. There will be hardly any difference. Now, since Python is a very hard, it's a very vast topic, so you don't need to learn the entire thing or waste a lot of time in learning the concept which will not be much of use. So, as discussed, we'll make a dedicated video on Python for Selenium in which we'll discuss about everything you need to know about Python. And if you want to take Java, you can take that approach also. You also don't need to learn everything in Java. You just need to learn the basic concept for which Selenium is required. So, the next point is Selenium. So, I guess we have discussed a lot about Selenium from overview point. Now, if you still have confusion, I will just request you to just stay with me for a couple of more minutes. As at the very end, I will just show you a small demo where we will just automate a simple use case. And where I will just show you how Selenium actually works. And not to mention, I will be making a dedicated video on Selenium where I will cover all the concept how we can automate from simple to complex scenario, and that too from scratch. So you don't need to worry about it. That video I will be uploading by the end of the week. Now, the third point for learning Selenium is test framework. Now, automation framework is not only required for automating Selenium, but for any application. It can be a REST API automation or any automation as a matter of fact. You will require a particular framework to streamline the overall process of automation. Now, let's first understand what actually automation framework is. So, in simple terms, automation framework is actually a collection of various functions. It can be some user-defined libraries or some external imported modules, and actually it's a collection of test data and various reusable modules which helps us to speed up and ease the overall process of automation. Now, apart from this, automation framework also enforces certain guidelines and practices to be followed to achieve a desired result. So, this is what in simple terms automation framework does. Now, let's quickly discuss why actually we need an automation framework. What's the requirement for it? So, the first and the most important reason is, in case of any small or big change, if we are automating it via automation framework, we can handle all those changes. It can be whether it's at the functionality level or whether it's at the test data level, very easily and with minimum code change if we are going through automation framework, as all the things modules are at one place. So, this is why this is where automation framework comes into picture. Now, the second reason why automation framework is very much required is, like, if we have an automation framework, there is hardly any manual intervention required. It's like you will get everything cooked and served at your table. All you need to do is you just need to trigger the run from framework, and all the tasks, and like it can be any test. If we want to run certain tests, if we want to skip certain tests, all will be handled at the framework level. And additionally, there is also no need to monitor this test script dedicatedly. Once you start the test in automation framework, everything will be done as in when the steps comes. And once it's completed, the corresponding result will be shared via email if that particular email is configured. So the list is very long when it comes to why do we need a framework or what actually an automation framework is. But for now, let's just keep it till here only. We can discuss more in my coming video. And one last point, the framework which I would be using in this particular thing is PyTest framework. Since like with Python, there are two major framework is supported. One is PyTest and the other one is Robot. But in our case, we will be taking the PyTest framework. Now, the last thing which is on the list, which is also a very important thing, is learning to fetch data from database. Now, why do we need to learn extracting data or fetching data? So, initially when we are automating a simple application, we might not need this. But when we are automating a complex scenario or a big application, in that case, we need to isolate the data and the functionality in two different pieces so that we can run our test on multiple environment like test or prod or pre-prod environment without any code change. So for all this, we need to learn how can we extract data, how can we store data. It can be in Excel sheet, it can be in SQL DB or MySQL DB. So it's actually based on the requirement where we want to put the data and how we need to fetch those data. So, as promised in the starting of the video, I will be showing you a small and a very straightforward demo where I will just browse a website, will fill one simple contact form, and all this will happen via Selenium and Python. So, let's say this is our official website of pythonfreaks.in. Okay. So, what we have to do, I will just navigate to this contact form, and here I will find four text box like where name, email, subject and message needs to be submitted. Okay, so we will try to do this via Python and Selenium. Okay, so let's close this thing. Okay, and then this is the Python and Selenium code for it. Just give a run and see how things happens in a very simple and a very straightforward way. So like you can see, the browser opens, okay, and it filled all the data. So it just happened within a second, within a fraction of a second. So this is the power of Selenium. In detail, I will be making a dedicated video like how can we find the element, how can we actually feed the data, what all different data we can feed. So this was all about the overall roadmap with a small demo on actually how you can learn Selenium step by step. But if you think there is anything which I missed or is not covered in this particular video, please mention the same in the comment section below and we'll try to address that in the coming video. Now, before I end the video, would repeat the same point. This is just a roadmap or a blueprint how you can actually learn Selenium. But we'll be making a dedicated video on all the four points which we have discussed in the video. So, if you like the content or you want me to make the similar kind of content in future, so would request you to kindly subscribe to my channel so that you can get notified whenever a new video with respect to any automation topic is released. So, thanks again for watching this video till the very end. See you all in my next video.